curtains and bedspreads with it.
They make a paint for that?
Give your home the lasting look.
Boy, did we need Dutch Boy.
I am a professional athlete. I was an All-American in college, but you wouldn't know because I didn't play basketball. I was the leading scorer in America, but you wouldn't know because I'm not on any cereal box. That's okay. I don't play to be famous. I play because it's the greatest sport in the world. By the way, my name's Roy. Nice to meet you.
Ladies and gentlemen, your Los Angeles Lakers!
Yeah! Game time, everybody. Game time. Hey, that's right. Woo!
It's a doubleheader night of the NBA on TNT, playoff style. The Lakers on top of Utah, 49-36, in one of the most bizarre halves of playoff basketball you're ever going to want to see. It's time for the Nike Halftime Report. Ernie Johnson in Atlanta with Reggie Theus and Dominique Wilkins. 6 out of 44, Nate, Utah shooting, and they're still in the game.
You know, it's not so much that L.A. is playing well, it's just Utah's playing terrible. And they, like you say, they're right there in the game, but you know, if they can make some shots the second half, they can keep L.A. shooting basically the way they're shooting, they could have a chance to win this game.
Now, the Lakers not showing any killer instinct whatsoever. They should be up by 25 in the game already. It's just unbelievable with the way the Jazz are shooting.
And Shaquille O'Neal has 6 points right now in 10 minutes. Karl Malone, 1 out of 13 from the field, mirroring what's going on with Utah in the field goal department in the first half. Meantime, Eastern Conference semifinal. What a game tonight in Chicago. Lenny Wilkins, guys. They've lost 6 in a row in this building. But Mookie Blaylock, who had 31 in game one, picked right up there again. 3-pointers early, hit 6 out of 7 in the first half, and had 20 points in the first 24 minutes. Hawks up by 2.
Just controlled the tempo big time. He had Michael under pressure, and he can't do it all by himself.
Third quarter, that's when the Bulls really made their run in game one. But the Hawks had every answer this time. Again, Blaylock coming off and hitting the 3. He had 8 out of 9 on the night. And the Hawks getting some breaks. Leitner loses the ball. There's Deke. Mutombo had 19 on the night. They're up 74-68. Steve Smith sighting up a 3 and knocking it down. They're up 15. Smith had 27. But you know the Bulls are going to fight back. Tony Kukoc, a 3 of his own. The lead's down to 7. On the next possession, though, watch Christian Leitner. He draws some white shirts, doesn't he? 1, 2, 3 of them, and muscles it in for a couple. It was a little leaner, and he also had 18 on the night. Scotty, from about the same place he won the game the other night, with a 3-pointer. But the Hawks, this is their night. Steve Smith under pressure, bottoms it out.
And it's going, Ernie.
And it was going for the Hawks tonight. And they are going back to Atlanta, 1-1 with Michael Jordan and the Bulls. 103-95. Is your final score. Smith at 27. Blaylock had 26. Michael Jordan had a nice night for Chicago. 27 points and 16 rebounds. But Scottie Pippen says he shouldn't have to get that many.
Well, you know, they do have to pick up
the slack. Anytime we have to have Michael come in and get 16 rebounds, I mean, that's uncalled for. And then ask him to come down and score 30 or 40 points to pull us out of it. You know, he's not going to have that type of energy, especially having to chase Mookie Blaylock around. We got to have a bigger effort. We got to have a bigger effort from Dennis, from Luke. We got to avoid the technical fouls that Dennis is getting, and he got to play. He just got to play the game and stop looking for the fans to get him the uplift and just play.
Scottie Pippen with a little edge tonight because the Hawks went ballistic on Chicago. Outshot them 52% to 41%. And you see, the Hawks are 47-0, including the playoffs, when they shoot a higher percentage than the opponent does. And the Hawks were getting it done tonight. Dominique, what is your take on this series now? As we're 1-1, they're coming back for games back-to-back Saturday and Sunday at
the
Omni.
Chicago got to find out what their problems is and take care of it very soon before the next game, because right now it's a lot of distractions there. I don't think some guys know their role. You got to have other guys to step up, like Scotty and Michael said, that they really got to help that team get over the hump.
And Scotty coming in after the game and trying to shake things up a little bit. I think that's what the Bulls need.
Hey, listen, I thought he was right on the money with his assessment of the game. Talking about their energy level, talking about their inside game. Their inside game is Dennis Rodman getting offensive rebounds. His energy level is not there. Maybe he's not 100%. His leg, okay, one excuse, that's it. If you're not going to, he said it best. Scotty said that if you're not going to lead us in rebounds, don't lead us in technical fouls. Great point.
Michael Jordan after the game saying, look, it's one game we lost. I still think what a lot of you writers think, that we're going to win it in five. We shall see. Back with more on the Nike Halftime Report in just a second. Utah trying to take a 3-0 lead on the Lakers, but the Lakers lead it at the break, 49-36. We'll be back.
Hey, Brett. These guys have a beer menu.
This beer is made with lingonberries.
Ooh, and this one has a dash of espresso. Or a forbidden coconut.
Two Coors.
Since 1873, original Coors. Pure and simple.
Peach medley.
You see this? This beer has beer in it.
It happens every year in some of the most remote stretches of land in Mexico. And in the world of off-road racing, it's truly the whole enchilada. The legendary Baja 1000. A mountain of dust for those who can stand to eat it. And the end of the line for those who can't. That's why more drivers who challenge the Baja rely on the Duralast battery than any other. The same Duralast you can rely on in your car. Because it's the one we stock at AutoZone. The Duralast battery. Power you can depend on.
Perfect for any game, Domino's has the perfect play. Choose from three delicious crusts. There's classic hand tossed, crunchy thin crust, or big as a dunk, sweet as a swish. There's the ultimate deep dish. So make the call and have it all.
Domino's! Wow, now!
Call now, and you can enjoy a delicious Domino's pizza during the game. And why not add some of Domino's spicy buffalo wings or steaming hot breadsticks?
It won't print.
Still won't print?
Still won't print.
It won't print.
Jiggle the cable.
I jiggle. I'll jiggle again.
That's the light.
That's the light?
That's the light.
It won't print.
Won't print. What's the problem with the printer?
It won't print.
Can you print? It's not the printer. It's the computers. Hadley downloaded a virus off the web. Hadley.
IBM protects your network.
Housekeeping. Excuse me. Checking out?
Uh-huh.
We'll change the room.
Holiday Inn hotels are undergoing a billion-dollar renovation to make every Holiday Inn as good as the best Holiday Inn.
Oh, you're back. Your toothbrush.
That means we're changing a lot more than the sheets. Holiday Inn, on the way.
Hey, welcome back to the Nike Halftime Report. Tomorrow night here on TNT, the Knicks and Heat Game 2, New York leading 1-0, followed by Game 3 in the Rockets-Sonics series, tied at 1. Dominique, the Heat, squarely on the Heat in Game 2 of that series in their gym.
Well, that's a lot of pressure on the Heat right now. It's a must-win for them. If you're looking at this series, New York, on the other hand, can play very loose. They can come out with a lot of confidence, a lot of emotion, because they know they're going home with a chance to, you know, to win two games. So this is a must-win for Miami.
Zoe's got to stay out of foul trouble, and he's got to hit his free throws. You got to have him on the floor. Meantime, you worked the Houston game the other night. That's 1-1 now. How do you see Game 3?
I know the Sonics came out with live body. They were so aggressive. They trapped the Rockets all over the floor, and they did not make any adjustments. Hakeem Olajuwon has to make the defense adjust to him. You know, a lot of times when you play with three great players like they have, sometimes you have a tendency to wait for the other guy to take, you know, to take the aggressive stance. He's got to come out and really get after it in the middle to make their defense come on all over him.
I like the dramatic pause there, too. I was riveted there for just a second.
I had to do that. I learned that in acting class.
Change of venue tomorrow night. They're going to be at Key Arena. We'll be back with more in just a second. Shaquille O'Neal, 3 fouls, 6 points. Lakers leading by 13.
Sierra, you got to pause this.
We were on vacation.
Oh, your sunglasses!
When we realized we were sitting on a gold mine.
Rubber sunglasses.
Too bad none of the stores saw it that way. So we looked into getting our own store.
How much?
Maybe we need a catalog.
How long? So, any more bright ideas?
Actually, yes.
I can see clearly.
Our own website.
It's gonna be a bright, bright, sunshiny day.
Soon we were open for for business everywhere. And before we knew it, we were selling shades to everyone under the sun.
Open a storefront on the internet with the most powerful network in the world.
Do I like to shop?
Oh, yes.
How you doing? Franks and beans?
Aisle 5.
Beans and Franks?
Aisle 7.
Hi.
Hi.
Fat free. Nothing but car. Check this out.
You are 1 millionth shopper.
Even at the supermarket, you can do more with the American Express card.
I love this card.
The NBA Finals. The World Series. The Stanley Cup Finals. The Daytona 500. And the Super Bowl. Until now, there was only one man behind the scenes at every event. His name is Bill. He delivers the Gatorade. Twist off a winning cap, and you too are headed to all five of the greatest sporting events of the year. Just like Bill, without all that heavy lifting.
Want to make your car look new? Armor All Protect It. The dash, the tires, the trim. It's new car juice. It doesn't just shine, it protects. So your car doesn't just look new, it keeps looking new. Armor All.
It's always been my way or no way, right? So when I go away, I stay at Super 8. I want it comfortable. Am I right? I want my VIP discount and friendly people. But not too friendly.
Life's great at Super 8.
Oh, there's nothing like working with a trained actor. Remember, Inside the NBA is still to come tonight. Join Virtual Boy Vince Cellini with Lindsey Hunter as they wrap up the night in the NBA playoffs. Time now for the garage door. See you, folks.
The Krylon Touch
means making the old look new.
The Krylon Touch.
And the boring becomes beautiful. Show your true colors.
Don't just paint. Give it the Krylon Touch.
Only with Krylon.
I don't know, but it's been said. Athlete's foot's as good as dead. Mighty Mike.
No cooling action.
Stops the itch and cools the burn. Penetrates to kill the germ. Athlete's foot, don't let it win. Stamp it out with Mica 10.
The new Firestone FT70C was tested at 50 miles per hour against the Goodyear AquaTread 2. The difference in the Firestone tire is Unity technology. The Firestone FT70C stopped an average of 12 feet shorter than AquaTread 2. Your results will vary, but that's a lot of feet. The difference is Unity technology in the new Firestone FT70C. Get a $25 certificate from the Sharper Image when you buy four Firestone FT70C tires.
Westlake has the tools and the know-how to help you get things growing.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
Make quick work of trimming and edging with McCulloch's Quick Start Lightweight Gas Trimmer. For help in the garden, get this Ace Round Point Shovel or 16-tine Bow Rake, both with sturdy fiberglass handles.
E-I-E-I-O.
So come to Westlake for the tools and the know-how to grow it right.
E-I-E-I-O. Oh, yeah.
Check out these great deals during Ford Truck Month.
Lease a new Explorer Sport 4x4 for only $299 a month during Truck Month at your local Ford dealer. Get Explorer's premium sport package with a V6 engine, 16-inch chrome wheels, step bars, and more. For $299 a month, Explorer Sport is ready to take you anywhere.
And what's so crazy about that?
A new Explorer Sport for just $299 a month. See your local Ford dealer during Ford Truck Month.
Gonna buy me a Ford truck and cruise it up and down the road.
Welcome back to the Forum in Los Angeles. 49-36 is the score. The Los Angeles Lakers on top by 13 with Quinn Buckner, Kevin Harlan. Utah shooting 14%. Yet they trail by 13 points.
They're not out of the game because they've been able to get 12 offensive rebounds out of their 24. And I think that's helped. They've gotten shots, but they've been able to get to the foul line more importantly. And the Lakers have not been in any real offensive flow. So at this point, if you're the Jazz, you have to come out and see can you assert yourself the first 5 minutes of the third quarter to see if you have a chance to pull one out here early and essentially take, I think, all of the spirit away from the Lakers should the Jazz somehow miraculously walk away with a win after shooting just 14%.
Malone there, 1 of 13, Stockton 0 of 5. They have made 22 points
at the free throw line of their 36. And the Lakers, 17 of 23.
Yeah, the 23, 22, almost as many as the Lakers have taken, because the Jazz, I mean, they've been a veteran team. But at some point, you've got to start making shots. You're not going to be able to stay in the game, you know, by just getting to the foul line. And at this point, you've got to start scoring and keeping them from scoring. So the combination is this. The Lakers have to come and play really enthusiastic and try to get as much out of Shaquille as they can while they've got him on the floor.
Well, I'm sure there are very interesting conversations in both locker rooms. And here we go, starting our second half. Ostertag and Ori tangling up inside. A foul called on the Los Angeles Lakers and Robert Ori. He's got two.
So you come out of the halftime, and the Jazz get exactly what they want. They get a foul on someone. They parade back to the foul line. Give this older team, if you will, a little bit more of a break. They don't have to run when they stay on the foul line.
You know, Quinn, going into this series, the question was, is Ostertag's ability to challenge O'Neal the key? Out through two and a half games, what do you think? Is that the key to this series?
I think what's been as much the key is not only Ostertag's ability to be in position, because I don't think one man in this league can stop Shaquille O'Neal. Good, great offensive players, that's not going to happen. But the Jazz as a team, their team defense has been very solid, coming quickly on the double team and then rotating to the proper man.
Shaquille O'Neal has played the first half in foul trouble, had three. Got his third in that second quarter. Here's O'Neal, quickly doubled by Hornacek and Ostertag. Snapping it back to Ori, back into the double team to O'Neal. He got it to go, Shaquille O'Neal.
You got a repost. You get it. If you don't have anything, throw it back, and then his teammates have to have enough confidence in Shaquille to throw the ball back to him and let him get it. He'll get it, and he'll get it and just be a little patient. Now he throws it and just try to reestablish position, and he just has Ostertag trying to recover. He makes the shot and the foul shot.
I can't help but think they didn't give that Laker offense some rhythm and some tempo, too, back and forth.
It definitely does, but it gives Shaquille also better position so he can get into the paint.
Stockton tries to maneuver out of trouble and finally gets free and then takes it right back down the throat. Hornacek with the runner. Oh, he hits a nice shot on the fly.
What was that? What? So you go from not making any baskets to making one like that.
Eddie Jones. That was a pretty play.
Well, that's the Lakers. That's what they can do with these young guys, especially with Eddie Jones. And that's one of the reasons he has not been quite as effective. He hasn't been allowed to run. You can see the season's averages compared to the series against Portland. Game 1, 17 had none. Just an awful night, 0-for-3 for shooting. Had 5 assists, 2 rebounds, but just could not get in the floor. Getting him up and down the floor helps.
8 points tonight, 2 rebounds for Eddie Jones. Stockton. Outside, Hornacek hits. And so Utah going counter to what we saw in the first half of their shooting.
Law of averages catch up with it at some point. They really do. I mean, that's why they're averages, for the good and the bad.
O'Neal saw an opening there because he had single coverage with Ostertag, but he missed nonetheless, and it's picked up by Karl Malone. Stockton. Malone can't hit. Still can't hit. Rebound by Ori. Malone is 1 of 15 from the field. There's a travel on the Lakers.
Yeah, because Stockton got in position. Point guards, one of the tough things to do is Karl Malone is struggling. Now 1 of, I believe, 14 inside. You have to turn and find the defense before you turn to run. Van Exel tried to do both and got called for the travel as Stockton stepped in his way.
Minute and a half gone. Here is another wide open jump shot for Jeff Hornacek. He is now hit. 2 of 3 to begin this half. 4 of 8, 16 points.
They ran a little decoy offense. They acted as though they post Malone on the strong side and the weak side. With Shaquille, you can run off the screen because Shaquille won't step up. And that's how Hornacek got the shot. Timeout. Good effort.
It's a 20-second timeout. You take a look at Jerry Sloan. I can't help but think, Quinn, that these coaches, especially in playoff basketball, really earn their money when adjustments need to be made after a half. But right now seems to me to be a very important time in this game.
Well, at the start of the third quarter is always an important time. I'm not sure how many adjustments that Jerry Sloan had to make. What he had to do was tell his team, we'll make some shots.
To Scott Hastings.
Thanks, Kevin. Spoke with Dale Harris at halftime about his concerns. He held Utah, obviously, to 14% shooting. He said, but this game is not over. We should have, if you look at the stats, only turned the ball over six times. We should have a 20-point lead. He is concerned, and as you saw by that quick timeout out by Utah, he thinks that they still got a chance to win this game.
That goes back to what Quinn was saying in the first half. He said this is a game that they should come out with unbelievable emotion and passion, and you just didn't see it.
No, not only the passion, they didn't have the purpose. It's this passion and purpose, and they didn't seem to have either one, but were able to get a lead.
Because this game has been labeled a must game by Del Harris. It's turned over by Utah, some pretty stingy defense by the Lakers, and Eddie Jones trying to work on Hornacek.
Now this is an aggressive Eddie Jones. He wants to take him off the dribble.
Little isolation for a three. O'Neal will not be outdone by Ostertag. Van Exel. O'Neal.
That's offensive.
And a foul, number four on Shaquille O'Neal with 9:30 to play in the third.
Yeah, that was offensive. The right idea was there with Shaquille, but now he's picked up his fourth. And the right idea means Van Exel getting to the basket. Van Exel draws Ostertag, who does a good job positioning, and then gets back. Shaquille O'Neal goes up strong, but gets called for the offensive foul.
And it was about this time in game two a couple nights ago where O'Neal picked up his fourth, and the Lakers really held their own, stayed very competitive without O'Neal on the floor. Ostertag from outside, O'Neal the rebound.
Well, they can't plan on doing that very often. Not against any team, not a playoff team, can you plan to be without a guy that averages 27 points a game during the regular season.
A travel on Eddie Jones. O'Neal does stay in the game, although they make one substitution. That's Byron Scott, and he'll take the place of O'Neal. Yeah.
They'll go small and have to take Shaquille out. Shaq having trouble staying in the game because the Jazz do a good job of trying to put pressure on him. Brian Russell takes the ball to the basket strong there. A little fake from Ostertag, a little shove, and then just a bad foul on that one. And those bad fouls eventually cost you. Shaquille trying to go through Ostertag, picks up his fourth.
Now back to live action. Hornacek from 15 nails it. He's hit 3 of 4 coming out of halftime. And the Jazz to within 10.
Yeah, and the Jazz have the rhythm. They have an offensive flow. And Dale Harris knows it, and he's taking a timeout to try to reorganize his basketball team.
22nd timeout taken by the Lakers. So Dale Harris has done a couple interesting things here. He has taken O'Neal out because he has to. He has the 4 personal fouls. He has brought in Byron Scott, but now he suddenly faces a very hot shooting Utah team. The NBA playoffs continue tomorrow night right here on TNT with another doubleheader. 8 o'clock Eastern, it's the Heat and the Knicks. Game 2. Some people shocked about the Knicks win down in Miami in game 1. Then at 10:30 Eastern, it's the Rockets and Sonics in game 3. That series tied at 1 win apiece. And it's followed by Inside the NBA with virtual Vince Chiellini. As you take a look at, well, there was Diane Cannon in there someplace, and then next to her was Magic Johnson through most of the first half. There she is.
I don't think
Magic was right next to her just a second.
You've been out finding the stars. I've been trying.
Well, I've been invited to a few post-game parties, I must be honest with you. Here's Campbell into Ostertag.
Offensive. Oh, they gave him
travel.
I'm sorry, but there's no doubt. But that's what Ostertag brings to this team. They had Felton Spencer, who played the position. Defensively, didn't have the same mobility. Ostertag positions himself well, and that's one of the reasons the Jazz think they have a better chance to win the championship this year than they've ever had before.
Utah's on a 6-0 run. Malone is 1 of 15, but he works on Ori. And he dumps it out to Russell for 3 in the miss. It's Los Angeles out of the fray. Here comes Scott feeding to Van Exel. Touch pass, Scott to Kersey. Rebound Malone. That's where he is held, and he's got 10 points. 10 rebounds tonight on his 11 points. Double-double.
He's been able to keep himself involved. Hornacek is hot. This is a man that's in the zone. He's in that rare air.
He's gone 5 of 6 since halftime.
Yeah, he's come out looking for shots, and he can make shots off balance, give his team an offensive lift, and carry it until Malone starts to come along.
Campbell remains ineffective. Picked up by Russell. Momentum has switched out completely to Utah early in the third. Stockton.
Tough shot. Tried to take a runner.
Lakers need some points and some ignition. Can they get it from Van Exel?
Oh, good
time. He missed the jam. Picked up by Utah. Stockton with it. 2-on-1 and a foul called on Ori.
I have seen Nick Van Exel twice attack his team because they have not made plays. He gets mad at Robert Horry because he didn't finish, and I'm sure it's out of frustration because it's well-timed to get him right there, and Kersey just throws it to the back of the rim, and you can see Nick Van Exel right there with that reaction saying, you've got to make that, and he did the same thing to Eddie Jones when he had a position, a mismatch out front and didn't take it to the basket.
Screen by Ostertag. Scott bought through it. Hornacek at two. He's gone 6 of 7. Hornacek has gone mad. And he is caught. He's brought Utah to within a 6-point reach of the Los Angeles Lakers. 55-49, Los Angeles, halfway through the third quarter.
NBA playoffs on TNT, brought to you by Genuine Chevrolet, the cars more Americans trust, by Dutch Boy Paints, give your home the lasting look of Dutch Boy, and by Fila, change the game.
Only by going alone in silence can one get into the heart of the wilderness. All other travel is mere dust and hotels and baggage and chatter.
Kid, you got the talent, but you got a problem.
You're too nice. I'm gonna make you bad.
Okay, Mr. Lambert.
Go to the net. Now connecting to the NBA. Welcome to NBA.com, the official website of the NBA. You have gained full access to all 29 teams and their players. Check out nightly scores and stats, read the latest NBA news, visit the NBA Theater and relive spectacular plays. Browse the NBA store, even enter a live chat session with an NBA player or coach. The online world of the NBA, only at NBA.com.
Jeff Hornacek has started 6 of 7 from the field. The Jazz have gone 6 of 11 to begin this second half. And the Lakers, when they could have put Utah out, Quinn didn't, and they let him hang around. And Jerry Sloan got his troops ready, and they've come out to within 6 to begin the second half.
They've gotten off to a good start. They've scored as many baskets in this first few minutes here, 6 minutes, than they did the entire first half. And they had Jeff Hornacek. They've been able to find him, and he's knocked down. He's on a 10-0 run by himself.
Robert Horry with the big basket for the Lakers, who needed something positive. They lead by 8. Malone. Up to Russell. Works around Kersey. There's Ostertag. He traveled with the ball. Utah has a 7 turnover.
Yeah, they've been able to. They haven't turned it over much, and that's one of the things that kept them in. You know, in that first half, they lead the league in assists, as well as field goal percentage. But in assists, they had 3. They averaged 26 a game.
Kick it. He's up 24-second shot clock, 6:10, third quarter. I'll look at our Chevy scoreboard. And Chicago tonight losing to Atlanta. Chicago had won 13 consecutive playoff games dating back to game 6 of Orlando beating Chicago in Chicago in 1995. What a pass! Campbell got it inside, and a great feed from the perimeter and Scott.
Yeah, you got to break the defense down. I think that's what they need a lot more of Nick Van Exel if they can get it. But at this point, they'll take it wherever they can get it with the Lakers.
Kersey. And a foul on Karl Malone.
Miscue there. Byron Russell and Stockton just didn't make the connection. They miss it, but you can feel the flow of the forum moving back to the Lakers. Unbelievable. 2 turnovers in 96 minutes. Second turnover of the series. That's pretty strong.
Up 3 by Van Exel, and he can't get that. Rebound, Russell. Here comes Utah. Now an Isley back in on the point. They got Ostertag, Russell, Malone, and Hornacek, who is on fire in this third quarter, 6 of 7.
I try to get Hornacek making the pass to Karl Malone.
Right there, you see it. But Karl Malone, 1 of 15, cannot buy a basket. But he is rebounding well. He's got 10, and he has 11 points.
You know, for young players, or as you play this game, the thing that you find out about the really good, really great players, if they don't score the natural way, one way, they figure out how to be effective for their teams in other ways. Karl Malone shoots as many foul shots as anybody in the league. What he's managed to do is keep himself in position to get fouls so he can keep some offense going for his team by virtue of that they keep a little offensive flow even though they're still down by 9.
Malone in the regular season shot 60% against the Los Angeles Lakers. Tonight, well, 1 of 15, that pretty much spells it out where he is tonight. 5-18 to play here in the third.
But if the game gets close, he will still take the tough shot and very subject to make that shot. He has that kind of confidence.
Yannick Zornizley. Hornacek was knocked out. Thus Scott is free and goes down the lane. There is a great screen set on the wing which sprung Scott.
But part of that, though, too, Kevin, is Scott made jump shots in the first in game two. So everybody's coming out close to him. And when you do that, he can put it on the floor.
Screen by Ostertag. Hornacek free.
Oh!
Shoot in!
He got fouled, too. Oh, and Ostertag is down on the ground, and it must look like he got poked in the eye. So they're playing 5-on-4. They need to foul him on the ground. I don't think anybody knows it.
Van Exel?
The Lakers don't even know it.
Van Exel and Isley makes the foul. That's the fourth on Isley.
Well, let's hope that, you know, that he's all right, but he looks like he's got his hand on his knee. And, boy, that would be a tough blow. It definitely is his knee. The doctors and the trainers have it, and they're holding it. We'll get a chance to take a look at him. He's right there.
Working against Kersey.
Yeah, he just kind of stepped back on it. Looked like he hyperextended it. But at any rate, they have the trainers out looking at him to see that he's okay. He is in some pain.
Call your cable operator today and ask about CNNSI, the sports news network.
It's time to set the record straight on resale value. In full-size pickups, there can only be one king of the hill. There is, and his name is Chevy. Chevy, the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. Long live the king.
Great values are in full bloom at your truck and van center at Olathe Ford. Olathe Ford grows Kansas City's largest selection of F-Series, Explorers, Vans, Rangers, Expeditions, heavy-duty trucks, and conversion trucks and vans. Pick an F-150 XL 4x4 flare size or 1998 Windstar from only $18,995. Use your green thumb for great values at Olathe Ford's truck and van center today. Only at Olathe Ford, just east of I-35 on 150 Highway, next to Olathe Lincoln Mercury.
We play the Royals, I'm 29. We play the Royals all the time. Swing, made a swing, yell from the seat. Got your own personal luxury suite. We play the Royals, I'm 29. We play the Royals all the time. Yeah, Blue Crew's playing in your home tonight. We play the Royals, I'm 29.
They just took Greg Ostertag off the floor, holding onto a knee.
Yeah, but this part here, he gets hit, but he gets banged a little bit. But if he's still able to run, he's fine. It was a little bit after that where he became awkward.
Right there.
And trying to keep his balance. And then from there, he just went down. He's got that knee up. They're trying to move it. They'll take it and try to move it back and forth. I didn't see him wince a lot, but he probably, you know, I don't want to get medical here, given that I haven't gotten a chance to see that firsthand in my medical school class. I wasn't very good.
You have been called doctor from time to time. Here's Foster checking in. 4.5 to play in the third. Hornacek has scored all of Utah's points. He's hit 7 in a row, 7 of 8 in the quarter. the Jazz down at halftime by 13, trail by 8. Now, make it 10.
And Scott has just been a load again for the Lakers. Coming in to play and be really active. But he, you know, he got the shot because he kept moving.
Isley, Hornacek, Karl Malone. He still can't get it to go. 1 of 16 for Malone. Unbelievable. That Exel against Isley. Look out, here he flies in for two.
Greg Ostertag makes a difference on that play with Van Exel because he's good at positioning. Foster's not a shot blocker. Smart play by Van Exel to take it to the basket.
So Foster replaces Ostertag. Malone, Hornacek, Isley, and Russell. The Utah five. Isley replacing Stockton. Hornacek's been hot. He's at 7 in a row. Does he make it 8? He does!
I told you, he can get in the zone. He can get in the zone where he can make shots in traffic. He's as good as anybody, both getting on a roll, but making shots in traffic. And that was a difficult shot. Byron Scott all over him.
Hornacek, 8 of 9 in this quarter. Van Exel with a nice spin move down the lane.
And if Jerry Sloan is going to Greg Foster telling him, you got to come off and help.
3 minutes to play in the third. Malone trying to get free. Isley shifting to the defense. Campbell on Malone. Carl is 1 of 17 shooting. Well, Saturday, our friends over at NBC have more NBA action. It's a doubleheader. First at 1 Eastern, it's game 3 of the Bulls and the Hawks, now tied at 1 apiece. Then at 3:30 Eastern, it's game 4 of the Jazz and Lakers. And don't forget, it's all underway with Showtime at 12:30 p.m. Eastern on Saturday on NBC.
They had a substitution. They brought Keith in for Foster because he didn't come over and help out Nick Van Exel.
Russell right by Van Exel. Ori coming up big, climbing the ladder for the rebound.
I try to find Byron Scott.
Look out. Van Exel. Call a timeout.
He did. Oh, I don't think there's any chance he had that on the way out.
Well, doesn't matter what you think.
It clearly doesn't. But as an opinion, I'm allowed to give. Yes. I did not agree with that one. It looked like Van Exel, the ball was, I mean, it looked like he was trying to capture it.
He's yelling timeout.
Timeout. He doesn't have the ball in order to call timeout. He called timeout before he had possession.
Good observation.
Here comes one. Oh, an 87 Buick station wagon.
Got it.
74 Volkswagen Beetle. A 285 horsepower V8 6-speed 1997 Chevy Camaro Z28.
Yeah, but what color?
Yo, man, being out here in L.A., I don't know how you can avoid not getting caught up in the hype.
Well, don't talk to me about the parties. Ask me how it is in the paint. You want to know the truth about the paint? You can't handle the truth, Bill.
They bow you.
They grab you. They foul you on purpose. The game is mental, Bill.
It's all mental.
It's not about your physicality or your abnormalities.
It's where your head's at.
Mental. Mental. Coming out here partying all the time.
No.
Focus.
Game.
Game.
We did the smart thing.
And bought the worst house in the best neighborhood.
Boy, did we need Dutch Boy.
It really lasts, especially on the outside.
And it makes the inside look beautiful.
We trust Dutch Boy.
It handled Jenny's science experiments.
And Bobby's soccer tryouts.
And still looks good enough to make the neighbors jealous.
Thanks to Dutch Boy, we have the best house in the neighborhood.
Well, at least we have the best paint job.
Give your home the lasting look.
Boy, did we need Dutch Boy.
Lakers by 12 with an Ostertag injury report to Scott Hastings.
Thanks, Kevin. I'm back here by the Utah Jazz locker room. Team doctors in with Greg Ostertag as we speak. They don't think he tore anything and that it's nothing more than a slight sprain. They're going to ice his knee, let it set for a while, see if he can maybe get up and walk on it. Kim Turner, public relations director for the Utah Jazz, said you may see him in the fourth quarter, but right now they don't think it's anything serious, but they are going to ice the knee and see how it responds to that.
So no Ostertag, at least for this quarter, maybe longer, and no Shaquille O'Neal, who Quinn picked up his fourth foul about 7 minutes ago.
Yeah, obviously it's a bigger problem for the Lakers than it is for the Jazz, but I think Osatag is a big part of them controlling the middle.
Campbell. Malone, out of bounds, off of Utah.
That's a good call. Billy Oaks was right on top of that call. Karl Malone tried to not touch the ball, and sometimes you don't touch it to make it look as though the other team hit it out, but there were three Jazz, and Karl Malone was the last, I think, to touch the ball.
2:17 in the third quarter. Game three, Western Conference Semifinals. Rebound by Russell. Boy, did he get hot.
Boy, he got up, and then he went up a little bit higher after he caught it.
Here comes Isley. Into Malone, and 1 of 18 for Karl Malone.
You know, it looks almost like Karl Malone is as concerned about getting to the foul line and maybe more so concentrating on that than finishing baskets. And that's one of the reasons I think he's missed some shots.
Heisler's got 5 fouls. He picks that one up.
And Stockton has 3. Van Exel taking advantage of his quickness, and you see Howard Eisley.
1:55 here in the third quarter. So Utah had 2 stretches of 11 misses in the first half. They shot 14% for the first half. LA led by 17. Stockton was ineffective. He was 0-3. In this second half, Hornacek has scored all 8 Jazz field goals. He has gone 8 of 9 from the field and resuscitated what appeared to be a dead Utah ball club.
There's one thing to miss shots. There's another thing to not exert some effort. And I thought both teams lacked that in the first half. I'm not sure that the Jazz came to win a game today. I think they came to play a game. And I didn't see, and I talked about the Lakers, I didn't see the purpose that they needed to have, but they've been fortunate enough to have even Shaquille on the bench and still have a lead here of 13 points. I think they've been very, very fortunate.
The amazing thing is, as you pointed out in the beginning of the broadcast, as Adam Key hits his first, is it for the Lakers? Their coach said this is the most important game of the year for them. It's a must-win situation. Our team is down 2 games tonight. We lose tonight, and the series is in dire straits, in real jeopardy.
Well, they were, not only that, you've got a young team, and they just don't make their young teams don't adjust well. Now, mind you, I don't think the expectations on this team were realistic. Shaquille O'Neal is a great player, there's no doubt about it. But you're talking about a team that has 4 players from last year. To try to take that and move it into the NBA Finals is a pretty difficult task. I don't care who you are.
Eisley's got 5 fouls, and he's got to watch Van Exel hit a 2 and a fadeaway, and a beauty it was from Nick Van Exel. He is registered 17.
Got his own offense going, too. That's not the Laker offense. That's Nick's offense.
13-point lead for L.A. They've led by 17. Utah, not surprisingly, has never led. Russell, Campbell, little mismatch here. Van Exel thinking he might double. There goes a driving Russell, and rebound by Travis Knight. Torn away by Russell, a fresh 24 for Utah. Under a minute to play in the third.
Isley needs to get the ball. This offense is at the point that you need someone that can get the ball and make plays. Hornacek can go because he can shoot it, but Isley can get to the basket.
Hornacek to Malone. Karl Malone finally hits just his 2nd basket tonight.
And you got to watch him coming alive. If you missed as many shots as he's missed, there's still a good chance that he can go on a roll.
He is 2 of 19.
Doesn't do much for his field goal percentage, that's for sure.
That excellent. 8 to shoot. He's got Russell again. Out to Scott. Shot clock at 3. Look at the speed of Scott! Oh, baby, what a play!
He makes a tough play. He's down. And they don't call an offensive foul. Oh, and the officials, they get a timeout. Or did he just hold it? The reason they don't call this, I believe, is because they think that Brian Russell is standing too far under the basket. Byron Scott is still down.
And Utah will inbound as Scott is out of bounds. A 3, Hornacek, just his 2nd miss in this quarter. Out of bounds over the backboard. His body is on the floor. It's a little bit odd that they would resume play, but they did, and now 11 seconds remain in this third quarter.
Unless, no, the only reason that they stop in a professional game, if they want to stop, the Lakers have to stop it. The officials don't stop it necessarily because someone gets hurt. You see Byron takes the ball to the basket strongly, and he goes down, and you can see he has no chance to protect himself, can't get his arm down. His shoulder looks like the first thing they hit it, but he's moving around a little bit, and it looks as though he's probably all right. You see Byron Scott is there, and he goes down. So he's down there, and that's Gary Beattie standing over the top talking to him. So the Lakers have just taken a full timeout because what they tried to do was delay the game to see if Byron Scott was going to get up, and when he didn't get up, the officials let him play, but they've since taken a full timeout.
That voice you heard was Dick Bavetta, who is one of the most highly regarded referees in the history of professional basketball, and the guy who just came over and by his relationship with the broadcast business has with these referees, and there is Byron Scott's wife, and Byron is still down.
Yeah, but I think he's all right. I mean, it may be sore. It'll be sore tomorrow, I can assure you of that. But he's not in a position that where I think we all thought he was initially, where it looked as though he'd have to come off on a stretcher. So he's obviously been able to get through that. They're talking to him. He's aware.
Anita, his wife, watching from just off the baseline. You know, there's Gary Beattie, too, the trainer from the Lakers.
They're looking at a little bit. They're looking at his wrist. I mean, it's not, it doesn't look like as much his shoulder as it is his wrist. And they've got the doctor over there. Dr. Lombardo is one of the doctors standing there. And Gary Beattie talking to Larry Drew, the assistant coach right there in the dark suit. And I think they're going to take him in and probably have it x-rayed just to be sure that nothing's happened.
Well, if you got to go out of the game, what a great way to go out with one of the most spectacular plays we have seen tonight as his wife, Anita, follows him into the locker room.
Took it to the hole strong.
Wow, and so quick, too. Quick. A guy who's 34 years old.
You know what he's done, though? He's done what most guys, when they get past their 30s, do if they stay in the game until they're 34. He's taken very good care of his body. He lifts weights. And he's set to, you know, and he knows that if he'd have done what he's doing now when he was at 24, he'd probably be able to play a few more years.
Final seconds of the third quarter. What a third quarter it's been. Ben Exel doubled. Kobe Bryant, good if it goes. He can't get it to drop. So we've come to the close of three. The star, Jeff Hornacek, taking center stage. 8 of 10 from the field in the quarter, 16 points. He keeps Utah alive. Go down 72-59.
At Pennzoil, we know brutal driving doesn't just take place on a racetrack. It begins at the end of your driveway. You stop, you go. You stop, you go. If this reminds you of your commute, we recommend you use Pennzoil Motor Oil. Pennzoil, formulated for today's stop-and-go driving.
Morning, Bob.
Morning, Henry.
Stop, go, Pennzoil.
Be active, be cool, but beware. Use an ordinary stick antiperspirant, you get flaky white stuff. Until now. Gillette introduces new Clear Stick. It's clear, so it can't leave a white residue. And it glides on smooth and dry for maximum strength stick protection. No stick protects you better against odor and wetness. So don't get the white stuff. Get the clear advantage. New Gillette Clear Stick. Or try cool, refreshing clear gel.
Hi, folks. Bob at Blue Springs Ford. Join us this month for our annual Spring Fling event. Like this 97 Taurus. It's a great family car. V6 automatic, rear defrost. Only $189 a month. How about a 98 Windstar V6 automatic? Only $209 a month today. And for a limited time, if you purchase any new vehicle from Blue Springs Ford, you'll receive up to $300 in free nursery products. Our annual Spring Fling event here at Blue Springs Ford. If you don't come see me today, I can't save you any money.
I'm Ann Trujillo with the Jones Intercable News Update. Jones Intercable has dedicated its staff to providing on-time installations and service calls. This on-time guarantee states cable installers and service technicians will arrive for appointments on time or customers receive free installation or a $20 credit. The on-time guarantee is part of a comprehensive plan to provide outstanding customer service. Other elements include extensive staff training and extended service hours. This has been a Jones Intercable News Update.
This program is authorized under broadcasting rights granted by the National Basketball Association. Any publication, reproduction, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, or accounts of this game without the express written consent of the National Basketball Association is prohibited.
Seven Western Conference Semifinals. The Lakers lead 72-59. A myriad of stars here as Denzel Washington joins a host of other celebrities watching Shaquille O'Neal take it hard here in the fourth. And Eldon Campbell cleans up the miss, and the Lakers lead it 74-59.
And the Lakers are doing a much better job than they did in the first two games of cleaning up those kinds of opportunities. The Jazz got to all of those, I thought, on the majority in games one and two. The Lakers obviously are making a concerted effort here in game three to do that.
Malone over O'Neal. 2 of 20 shooting for Karl Malone.
That's the first time I've seen him react to the fact that he hasn't made a shot. Wince as though he can't believe that didn't go in.
Has to be one of his first shooting nights. What a pass to Campbell. What a pass to Campbell from Shaquille O'Neal.
That's one of the things Shaquille O'Neal has, an area that he can improve in. Everybody has areas to improve. That's one. Getting scores out of the double team for the Lakers.
Now the Lakers are coming out of this fourth quarter. Is a good sign, probably something that Del Harris needed to see. A little bit of fire now in this ball club. Needing a win tonight, down two games tonight. Russell for three. Morey, another rebound. Great pass to Campbell. Here comes Los Angeles. Kobe Bryant, who only played 4 minutes in game two, and who tonight has played 13 minutes. O'Neal, another good pass. This time Bryant, and he's fouled by the Utah Jazz.
Actually, that was great hand. The pass was a tough pass. You got 7 out of 10 people that can't handle that kind of pass. But Shaquille has got to be good out of the double team. So when he gets the ball, guys, first of all, have to move. You see Campbell cut. Shaquille goes up. As you see the traffic going down the middle, a mistake made by Russell, but a solid pass by Shaquille O'Neal, who made the last pass to Kobe Bryant, who I thought makes a better catch because Shaquille had it humming through there pretty good.
Well, the non-call. And as you see now, with three fouls, Malone off the bench. Byron Scott trotting at the top of your screen back on the floor after being examined, and that really energizes his crowd. To Scott Hastings.
Guys, Byron Scott in there looked at team doctor holding that right wrist. He came out. I asked him how he's doing. He says, I don't know. We're going to go out there and try and see. But it is the right wrist. And he will play, though, this sometime in the fourth quarter.
And that is his shooting wrist, of course.
It's his shooting wrist. He probably jammed it because he really tried to support his fall or break his fall with that. And if he's able to come back and play, they obviously feel comfortable that it's not broken.
Carr tries to bring out O'Neal and then charges at him. Here's Foster. Rebound by Carr.
He pushed off.
Yep. Foul on Utah.
Yeah, he pushed Shaquille O'Neal.
Antoine Carr. He has got four. Jerry Sloan, none too happy on that sideline.
Well, Jerry actually is a guy that, you know, will speak the truth. You generally see his reaction. I think he felt from the beginning that his team didn't have it. It didn't take him long to figure it out.
Bryant to the free throw line, fouled by Stockton, and he has four. The momentum is changing in this fourth quarter. You can feel it.
This momentum is already the Lakers. If it changes, then I think it'll go back to the Lakers, to the Jazz. John Stockton's problem with guarding Kobe Bryant is Kobe Bryant, even though he's big and handles the ball with long dribbles, can get down to short dribbles and can get there quickly. And that's what he just did to Kobe. I mean, to John Stockton.
2 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. Lakers by 20. By 21.
Yeah, it's got to feel good so far for this team, for the Laker team, but they can't afford to get lulled into any kind of false sense of security because the Jazz can come back in some games like this, but I don't see them with the energy and making the kind of plays they need to make. They haven't done it all game.
Kobe Bryant draws the foul. The Los Angeles Lakers have started this fourth quarter with an 8-0 run and lead by 21.
Once upon a time, there was a car that was elegant, spacious, and refined. In fact, it was protected by a warranty package that was one of the most comprehensive in the land. Introducing the 1997 Sonata. Is this a modern-day fairy tale? No. It's a whole new Hyundai.
Father's Day is a laugh till it hurts comedy.
Oh, my God!
All right, I'm sorry.
Riotously funny.
Yeah!
That's how it stops.
Robin Williams.
Ugly.
Billy Crystal.
Oh, boy.
Father's Day.
Thank you very much.
Rated PG-13. Starts Friday, May 9th.
I've seen every card there is. Thousands of cards. Super 8's VIP card. It says, congratulations. Your reservation is guaranteed, and you get 10% off. Life's great at Super 8.
50 seconds to play. Smith, long shot out of the
corner. Get up. Get a little bit upset about this.
Shot clock now at 10. Hardaway for three.
This is what we've been waiting for. The NBA
Picks. Lakers lead by 21. Let's take a look now at the Dutch boy in the paint statistics in that matchup. Karl Malone and Shaquille O'Neal. Now, O'Neal has been plagued by foul problems. He's got four. That's just 15 minutes.
Karl Malone is plagued by a basket that the lid won't come off of. He just can't buy a basket. And that's just been the sake of things for the Jazz. The Lakers have been able to get a little bit of production from everybody. Byron Scott gave him some good looks. Karl Malone just still looking to try to figure it out.
Here comes Karl. Got O'Neal out and drives into him. Rotation to Morris. Rebound by Ori. Quick outlet caught by Kobe Bryant. Eddie Jones. He's been quiet tonight. As he was game two, and a foul called on Morris. You know, you think about long-range shooting with the Lakers, and the Lakers, Quinn, in game two had 11 three-point shots. Tonight, they lead by 21. They haven't hit a single three-pointer all night long. As you see, Atlanta's earlier win tonight in Chicago over the Bulls. Asiata will join Vince Cellini inside the NBA in virtual land. We are in La La Land. Bryant to Ori. O'Neal, and they pushed him out, so he has to go back outside to Bryant.
But that's when he's starting to get a lot smarter, Shaquille. Look at him.
Oh, no! Robert Ori shows no mercy.
And that's where Shaquille is starting to be better. He knows the double team's coming, and the Lakers are doing a much better job of moving without the basketball. Had a little showtime with Bryant. And watch, get it in, there's Ori, and then cut to the basket, gets it back. Those are the kind of finishes I think you need to see more of Robert Ori. His foul shooting on an average has started to go down since he's been in the league, because I don't think he's stayed as aggressive taking the ball to the basket, relying on his three-point shooting.
Los Angeles on an 11-0 run to start the quarter. Utah has not scored in about 3 minutes. Morris out of bounds, off the Jazz, and everything beginning to crumble now for Utah and Jerry Sloan and for Los Angeles. They have seemed to hit their stride in this fourth quarter.
They caught a Jazz team, I think, that didn't come in here to win this game, and the Lakers have been able to get a little lead and then feed on it.
Bryant doesn't make it. They'll go to the free throw line.
But a part of what's happened here is the most aggressive team is the team that's getting the better end of any kind of doubt, benefit of the doubt, as you see Van Exel take a seat. And that most aggressive team has been the Lakers.
Five fouls on Carr, Kobe Bryant, and like we said before, this is just minimal minutes in game two. He's got 7 points tonight, and he's in double figures in terms of minutes played. Look at the difference in the benches.
Well, 30-7, obviously the Lakers have been able to get some great scoring. They've got five guys who scored. The Jazz won in spite of the fact that there was a 33-point scoring from the bench of the Lakers in game two and 17 for the Jazz, because they were able to get better production from their starters. That's the reason they won that game.
You know, we keep talking about Utah and how they played so well in the third, and they did. They only trailed by 13 at the end of three, but they're still only shooting 22% for the game.
If you're in the game shooting that, you're doing a heck of a job. You were talking about Kobe Bryant. Kobe Bryant's had 22 points in the playoff game already. I mean, he's a guy that gets up a shot almost every 2 minutes.
Shandon Anderson with a nice move on Jones. Rebound by Percy. Ahead to Bryant. They got Jones, and he flies inside and can't get that to go.
And he ran into Antoine Carr. I thought the officials were going to give him the benefit of the doubt.
Wide open Carr. O'Neal was back at the other end.
So that's the one thing that happens with Shaquille. When they start playing and running up and down, it's hard for Shaquille to change ends.
Lakers have led by as many as 25. Utah has scored 2 points here in this fourth quarter. Bryant won't count it, by the way. Foul called on Isley, and he is gone. So his sixth it is.
Yeah, that's it for him. They've got to put John Stockton back in the game, and I'm not sure this is something Jerry Sloan really wanted to do at this point, realizing that they have a little chance to get anything going. They prefer to keep Stockton on the bench.
So Isley has been a very credible backup for John Stockton. In fact, the Jazz really has very little drop-off. Stockton, one of the great guards in the history of the game, and a Hall of Famer to be. But with Isley, it's been a succession of other lesser-known backups, Eric Murdoch, Delaney Rudd, Jim West, John Prouty, and they have found a nice backup in Howard Isley.
I'm thinking about those names. It's like, yeah, he's a much better backup than those guys. No offense to those guys, but all of them, I'm sure, will say John Stockton. It's hard to find an equal with a guy who's the all-time assist and steal leader in the NBA. And those just don't come around very often.
Here's Stephen Howard, a 12th man on this team. Like his coach, Jerry Sloan was a 12th man back for Baltimore in the 60s. And Stephen Howard will go to the free throw line as a fifth foul is tagged on Jerome Kirsten. Stephen Howard, an interesting story. Went overseas to get better. And he's such a diligent worker. As a 12th guy, I guess you've got to be on a team like Utah. And his wife has been known to bring him lunch at the practice facility, so he won't break his routine. She'll deliver the lunch. He stays there and continues to work, and she goes back home.
Yeah, graduated DePaul University in, I believe, computers and mathematics. A very strong mathematic background. He's a guy that's just really kind of tried to find a way in the league. And the Jazz have done a good job with their low picks and non-draft play free agents.
Good point.
And getting guys who just fit into what they want to do. But the number one rule for them is you've got to come prepared to work hard.
O'Neal, he'll work hard here for two.
You know what was smart, though? They just gave him a technical foul. But what was smart, because he did not, he just threw him out of the game. Because for making, for kind of playing with the official. It was not anything ill-intended, but he put two fingers up to say 2 points once, and the official called a technical, and then Shaquille did it again. And here you are right now. The smart thing to do, he doesn't try to dunk it. He knows to go right up. Just take it easy. He's got size. Now watch him put his fingers up and to the official, and he goes the other way, and there's one technical, and then he does it again. To say, yeah, it's still good, but he's got to get off the floor. And then he gets mad at Dick Mavetta.
There's a size difference there. O'Neal over 300 pounds.
Uh-oh. No, he's better be careful.
He better be careful, or they'll take him out of the next game.
Dick Mavetta just tried to get him to walk off the floor, and he put his arm around him. And Shaquille, I think they're still seething over the whole thing that's happened in the last game, made it clear that he didn't want to be touched by Shaquille O'Neal.
To Scott Hastings.
Right.
Scott, are you there?
Yeah, sorry, I can't hear a thing. I'm right in front of me. Shaquille came down and talked to Billy Oaks and said, what did I do? The teammates tried to pull him away. He just said, no, I'm okay, what did I do? Billy Oaks was basically walked away from him and said, you're out of here. And that's when he got mad. Check said, well, I ain't going. And finally, that's what Dick Mavetta, the veteran he is, kind of walks Shaq off. As we know, if Shaq would have stayed on, he could have been fined by the league.
Stephen Howard on Jerome Kirsten. Howard gets it to go. Count it for two and center to the free throw line with 7:23 to play. And it's 88-66 Los Angeles.
And Jerome Kirsten just fouled out of the game.
Second player to do so, Isley fouled out moments ago for Utah. And he'll argue it.
Yeah, and this is the sign of this team a little bit, and this is the problem. If the official calls it, it doesn't matter at this point. You're not going to get anything else out of it. Get off the floor.
whether you like the call or not. And this is a very lenient crew as well, the Veta Durham and Billy Oaks. A very veteran crew, and then one with many playoff games under their belt. And in a game that has been very difficult to call, they've done a very good job. It's Travis Knight now takes the place of Percy, and we've got 7:23 to play in the fourth.
You know, we can sit here and say that they did not talk about the incident the other day where they felt the no call cost them the game. This is all a residual of that. When you see guys keep barking at officials in a game that's won for no reason, I don't care what the circumstances are, you got to let it go. You got to, you know, you're here looking at seven, you know, a 22-21 point lead. No need to worry about officials now.
Well, big question was how the Lakers would respond. What a play by Kobe Bryant!
Oh, you'll see that all day long with Kobe.
How can someone that young do something so spectacular? Wow! Travel on Stockton.
Are you saying that because you're young, you can't make great plays?
That was the play of a guy who's played many NBA seasons, not a kid who's just 18 years old who played high school basketball this time a year ago.
No, that's the guy that's just got tremendous basketball skills. Not only athletic skills, but he's got tremendous basketball skills. And Jerry West has said when they worked him out, they thought this guy had more skills than anybody they've ever worked out before. That's why they traded Vlade Divac for the rights to get to him.
Kobe Bryant, who has been a factor tonight with a lot of minutes.
Watch the
finish. Look very easy.
The best football player in America will not be seen on television this Sunday. Not while there's a Pro Bowlers tour. America did not see the best football player win a gold medal in Atlanta. America did not see the best football player win our only World Cup. Because all the networks agree, the best football player in America isn't good for ratings.
Baby Ruth presents Moments with Great American Heroes.
Sure, I'll level with you. I've lost a step.
I can't even make it around the world in 2 seconds anymore.
I'm not gonna kid you. I need a boost. The chewy nougat caramel and tons of roasted peanuts in a Baby Ruth is what I need to get me to hyperspeed.
Without that extra energy, I barely cracked the sound barrier.
Excuse me.
I had to stop a volcano from destroying Hawaii.
Any calls while I was gone?
Baby Ruth from Nestle. This baby gets you going.
Grant, it's time to look beyond basketball. I'm thinking made for TV drama.
You want me to be just like Tommy, Dad, but I can only be Jake.
After that, you go on tour with your book. Then you cut an album.
I'm a cowboy.
He's a cowboy.
So, what do we think?
I'd never do something like that. Care for a Sprite?
Knicks Heat tomorrow at 8. Get the NBA playoffs on TNT.
Kiki Vandeweghe, a longtime Los Angeles Laker who played with Denver, and that is not Kiki Vandeweghe. I don't think I want to know who that is.
Those are very much staunch Laker fans, to say the least. Maybe do for a haircut.
Here's Kobe Bryant, part of that great Laker bench attack tonight.
Yeah, the benches for the Lakers has come to play. 33-13. Bryant has got now 12 of that 34. And Byron Scott, who took a hard spill, has 10 of those. So they were able to get some from a little bit of the backcourt, more so than the front court. But they were able to get some help, which is what they needed, because you had to go without Shaquille because he got in foul trouble. He's now out of the game, but it does not matter. I don't think there's much chance. The Jazz can figure out enough offense to get it going. I think Karl Malone, we may have seen the last of him, unless Jerry Sloan decides to try to just let him get a little offensive rhythm.
Going into the game on Saturday here, which you can watch on NBC. Here's Carr ducking the defense of Kemp. Travis Knight, the rookie, gets the ball, gives it up to Bryant.
He's got a little bit of the Allen Iverson kind of dribble that's just short, if you will, upon the ball by some people's perspective. But, you know, as a former player, I say, if the officials let you do it, then you do it. You know, I hear a lot of people. Yeah, he traveled. I hear a lot of people complain about. But if people let, if the official lets you play that way, you play that way.
Yeah, a little different. The Stockton Malone combination.
I'll tell you what, they'll load up on Saturday. They will load up because they pride themselves, both of them, in coming and doing their job and doing them very well.
And even Howard.
And neither one of them played the way they could play today. I mean, I think that I'm not sure that the effort was there. They just did not get it done the way that the Jazz needed them to.
And this game was for the taking.
Yeah, this game was definitely for the taking. This game was for the taking until about 6.5 minutes, actually 5.5 minutes in the third quarter. They had, had a chance to give it away, and the Jazz could have taken it.
Robert Horry for three. He had 7 the other night in Salt Lake. Rebound by Stephen Howard. The Hornacek. A nice no-look pass. Shandon Anderson with the charge. Five and a half to play in the game.
Though Anderson picks up that foul. He's the brother of Willie Anderson, who's with the Miami Heat. He did for the Lakers, I thought, a very good job until he got hurt. He was the energy early in the season when the Jazz were playing very strong basketball. Then he got injured. They went back to a lineup that included other people. Adam Keefe got minutes. But Anderson is a guy they're really pleased with, and they like the fact that he was good energy.
Brooks and Carr. A lot of minutes tonight for Kobe Bryant over fellow rookie Shandon Anderson. Rebound by Knight.
Oh, great foul.
What a pass and what a play by Kobe Bryant.
That's what a guy can, that can jump can do. He can go on one side and finish it on the other. But Knight makes a very good pass for a big man to get the ball down there.
Here's Stephen Howard. 4:50 in the game. Controlled now by Los Angeles. Couple injuries in this game that probably should be noted going into game 4. As you see, Derek Fisher set the check in the conscience. But Osterjag's knee, he's gone. And the shooting wrist, the right wrist of Byron Scott, who has been a factor in the last 2 games.
I think Ostertag is the biggest. I mean, even though for the Lakers, that Byron Scott is the guy that may get your numbers. For the Jazz to do what they think they can do, which is win the NBA championship, get to the Western Conference Final, they need Ostertag because he has been defensively in position guarding Shaquille, hadn't scored a lot in his block shot, so he's done a very good job protecting the middle.
Bryant drove into a thicket of Jazz players inside the lane. A foul was eventually assessed. Shandon Anderson. Jerry Sloan is a guy that didn't get a lot of attention around the league. Well, in 9 years, he has put together some of the strongest team this league has seen.
He's got the longest tenure of any coach in the league. I think the next one is Phil Jackson. You're looking at about 8 years. So I think that the fact that he's been at the same place for as long as he has, says he's done a very good job.
Before that, he was Frank Layden's assistant.
Yeah, Frank Layden, who's now the president of the organization. And I think Frank Layden and his son Scott do a good job, again, finding talent. But Jerry Sloan is a guy who, he's a straight shooter, and he doesn't expect any one thing except come do your job. And he doesn't feel like he needs to tell you to come do that every day.
Kobe Bryant, 17 points in the game, 15 in this quarter. As it's gone to 96-71, it's all Los Angeles. They needed a win, and they're going to get a win over Utah. And so the series will go to 2-1. Utah's advantage, game 4, Saturday. Knocked away by Rooks. Picked up by Knight. Ahead to Derek Fisher.
Yeah, you've seen all kind of uncharacteristic things with the Jazz. Passes into the defense as opposed to away from it. Maybe losing some transition. They have not been able to do a good job, and I'm sure Dale Harris will try to take advantage of it. They've not done a very good job staying in front of Kobe Bryant.
Lakers have still not hit a 3 after hitting 11 the other night in Salt Lake. No threes in this game. Rebound by Knight. They like this rookie out of Connecticut, Knight.
Yeah, because he doesn't need the ball to be effective.
Corey Blount, the former Chicago Bull.
Well, Corey Blount had been out in the first 2 games because he had showed the problem. And they brought it. He actually kind of, the first game, he showed up for the second game. They didn't expect him to be there. But he was a guy that actually had played pretty well. He's a former teammate of Nick, not former teammate. He and Nick Van Exel played together in Cincinnati.
Here's Anderson. They got the run of the goal. And he was shoved inside. But the ball counted. Well, Chicago lost tonight, so that series is tied at 1 apiece. Now they go to Atlanta. And New York, I think surprising a lot of people with their win in Miami last night. That's a 1-0 lead for the Knicks.
Yeah, but they just beaten the Knicks. Miami had beaten And the Knicks had beat Miami just a couple of weeks before. So the Knicks felt pretty comfortable they could come in and steal a game. There's no doubt about it. The shocker is obviously Atlanta, after playing close in game one, winning game two, getting what you want out of the split. Now they have to go back and hold the whole serve, if you will.
Kobe Bryant goes high!
Goes high on a bad pass. I mean, I'm telling you, this kid's got talent. That pass was too hard, and he caught it and just took it up, put it in the basket. Even got Dale Harris to get a smile on his face.
Shandon Anderson with a nice reversal. 2:50 to play in the game.
So the Lakers can feel good about themselves. What they learn is that if they stay with it, they give themselves a chance. But I think they also found they should be realistic about it. They played a Jazz team that was not as effective as they've been. But at this point in the playoff, it doesn't matter as long as you get a win.
Travis Knight can't hit it, Keith with the rebound. And it was really the fourth quarter where it was unleashed by the Lakers. It's 13-point Laker lead at the end of three. 13 points at halftime, Lakers on top. Hornacek had an unbelievable third quarter. Just threw that one away off of Keith. Hornacek went 8 of 9 in the third. But this fourth quarter has belonged to Kobe Bryant. 18 years old, with spectacular play after spectacular play.
Reliable. Secure. Worry-free. Our new cars are not only backed by a warranty package that's one of the most comprehensive in the industry, but by every person who helped make them possible. Is this a new car company? No. It's a whole new Hyundai.
It's the final week of your local Ford dealer's year-end clearance. You only have till January 3rd to get year-end deals like this. Get America's best-selling car, Ford Taurus, for just $239 a month. Just $239 a month for a 97 Taurus, loaded with a powerful V6 engine, dual airbags, air conditioning, and more. $239 a month on Taurus during year-end clearance. Every Ford car is priced to move right now. So for your best deal on America's bestsellers, get to year-end clearance at your local Ford dealer now. This is the last week.
Whether you're a beginner, a long-time martial arts enthusiast, or just a Renaissance fan, you'll find everything you want at Odyssey Martial Arts Supply. Plus, all styles and sizes of martial arts uniforms, including our exclusive Odyssey line. Martial arts enthusiasts from all over the Midwest know they'll find everything they need at Odyssey Martial Arts Supply, 4315 Blue Ridge Boulevard.
Vince Cellini in virtual land, where tonight on Inside the NBA, Lindsey Hunter of the Pistons picking on somebody his own size. We'll take a look at what happened at the United Center. Mookie Blaylock was outstanding, and the Hawks have evened the series with Chicago. Who'd have thunk that? Plus, Charles Barkley chasing the elusive NBA title. We'll hear from Chuck as well. Right now, back to the forum, Mighty Quinn and Hollywood Harlan.
It's been all Los Angeles. This fourth quarter is they pulled out. Utah has shot 26%. They have only made 20 field goals. And the all-time record for fewest field goals made in a playoff game. Go back to 1994 and 95 when New Jersey and Cleveland each made 21. As you see right there. So, you could have some history in the making if Utah can't convert in the final 205, which is unlikely, but it could happen.
Believe me, they had six baskets in all of the first half. It's very easy for that to happen. Believe me. So for them to come up with another one here, the way they've shot it today is a minor miracle. Karl Malone just could not find the basket. So he gets a chance to get a break. And I suspect that you'll see a very inspired Karl Malone as he gets prepared for game four. Because he's a guy with tremendous prime, like most of these guys in this league. But nobody likes to come out and go. I mean, it was almost going to look like he was going for an offer.
It's amazing that this is the same Utah team we saw Tuesday up in Salt Lake City.
But it also tells you the nature of the game. And that's why, you know, if you're the Jazz, you can't afford to get yourself in these kind of positions. If you got a chance to close it out, go ahead and close it. Because what happens is you get a circumstance, they don't, you know, OSHA tag. You have to assume he'll be healthy, but if he's not, then you put yourself at risk having to go an extra couple of games there, and then you put yourself in a tough position for the conference finals if you get there.
Fisher wiggles his way for two. Minute and a half to play in the game. It's the Lakers 102 and Utah 74.
You see, Jerry Sloan's going to Hornets set to get Stockton out of the game. Because what he didn't want to do, doesn't want to do, when you're in a game where you've gotten yourself beat like this, you don't want to run the starters out if you don't have to. And if you handle the ball a lot, that's what can happen.
Well, Nick Daxel had a great game. He is our Bud player of the game. 29 minutes, 17 points, 5 assists, 4 rebounds. And a very staunch effort from Van Exel. And I think there were a lot of observers that came into the series feeling that for this Laker team to win, sure, Shaq had to play well. Sure, Campbell had to have some productive moments, but Van Exel had to score.
Well, I think both Van Exel and Campbell are the keys, because I think they give you the additional player. Obviously, you get somebody from the perimeter, and it makes you a little bit better and can handle the ball. But Campbell has got to give Shaquille some help down on the block to take some of the pressure off of him.
Sean Rooks followed by Stephen Howard. There's Byron Scott. His shooting wrist is of some concern now to the Lakers. He'll probably put a lot of ice in it if it's not already on there right now. And he will hopefully be hale and hearty for Los Angeles on Saturday. So he has been effective in the last two games.
You can see they've wrapped it already. They've already wrapped it. It'll be sore. I don't care what they do with ice, it will be sore on Saturday. The question is, can he play through it? Because one of the things that happens when you get your wrist like that, it's hard. It's not so much to get it to the basket, it's the follow through, which is a little extra extension that may be difficult to have. So I'm sure with today's technology, you know, getting a little, you know, rub down, massage, they'll do everything they can to make sure they get that wrist right.
And you said you weren't a doctor.
I guess it was pretty evident when I started to explain that.
Here's Stephen Howard, rejected by Kobe Bryant, who is glistened in this fourth quarter.
Well, you get a peek at the kind of talent that is there. And now as you start to add experience to that talent of Kobe Bryant, then you'll see a player that is going to be as good as anybody in basketball. He almost had that still.
Shandon Anderson into Howard. He got two. There are a lot of things about this series which are now beginning to take shape and take form, and one of which is that Shaquille O'Neal, although so many people predicted that he would have a huge factor in this series, has not been much of a factor. He's done about what people, well, what a lot of people thought he might do, but he hasn't done what people thought he could do.
First of all, it's unfair. And when Shaquille O'Neal went to the finals with Orlando, Shaquille O'Neal had Penny Hardaway, who is probably, Penny Hardaway is coming off being on Dream Team 3. They don't have anybody on the Lakers that is exactly in the same position. So it makes a huge difference, because Shaquille is in a dependent position where he depends on somebody else to get him the ball in order to make plays.
Chris Morris on the quick break. 104-81. Lakers in the seconds ticking off here in the fourth quarter. They got a win. They needed a win. It was a must game. Called the most important of the season by their coach, Del Harris.
They deserve credit. I mean, I don't care how ugly it is. They deserve the credit to the Lakers because they came and got it done. Playoff time, there's no such thing as a bad win or an ugly win as long as you get it done, and that's what the Lakers have done here.
So the Lakers survive an ejection of Shaquille O'Neal, an injury to Byron Scott, foul trouble for O'Neal most of the game. He got his fourth early in the third quarter. And even with a Utah team that was shooting so horribly in the first half, just 14%, Anderson connects for three. And with a chance to get back in, the Lakers held what kind of ground they could muster, and they go on to win the game.
They withstood Hornacek starting to get on the roll, and then all of a sudden they were able to get Kobe Bryant on the floor, and then Van Exel came and kind of popped it open for them. Now they got a chance to get themselves even in game four.
So a 12-0 start to the fourth quarter for Los Angeles. They took command of the momentum, and they go on to win it 104-84. They're led by the 17 points from Van Exel, the 19 points.